So now, having learned about corresponding and alternate interior and alternate exterior angles, we now go to the last type of angles, which is called as interior angles. Interior. Now, don't get confused. This is alternate interior. This is alternate exterior. Now, I'm going to talk of only interior angles. Don't get confused. Okay? Purely interior angles. So what are interior angles? What are the interior angles? Interior angles, very important. I hope this is clear. Is it seen? Okay. So let's say, so what are interior angles? Remember the word interior start. What is the starting alphabet of the word interior? I. So very easy to remember I. So these are interior angles. So you make a I. Suppose I make a, this looks like an I, no? I. That means interior angles will always be between the two parallel lines, just like your alternate interior angles. But alternate kya tha? Ek left mein tha, ek right mein tha. One was on the left, one was on the right. No, 3 was on the left, and 6 was on the right of the transversal. No, left right. But here interior angles both will be to the left and both will be to the right. So who are the interior angles? The pairs. So 3 and 5. One pair is 3 and 5, and the other pair will be 4 and 6. So don't get confused. 3 and 5. So what are interior angles? Interior angles I hai na, it's I. So, and then I ka beech wala stroke. Right? But only difference is in interior angles, both will be to the left of the transversal and both will be to the right. In alternate kaisa tha? Alternate was 3 and 6, 4 and 5. Remember 3 and 6, 4 and 5. Ulta ulta. Left, right. But here it is both left, both right. So 3 and 5, 4 and 6. This will be my interior angle. So I'll just rub it. So remember 3, 5, 4 and 6. 3 and 5, 4 and 6. So interior angles. I hope this board has not gone behind as I was writing now. So 3 and 5, as I told you, between the two parallel 3 and 5. So who's the number 3? CBE. Angle CBE. And 3 and I said what? 5. So CBE BEF. So which was that angle? Angle number 3 and angle number 5. So angle 3 and angle 5. Okay, you know this short form is for angle. No, you know that, no? That is a short form for writing an angle. Instead of writing the full word angle, you can put a short form. Now, whose other jodi? I told you one is 3 and 5 and other one be 4 and 6 between the lines. Both left, both right. Okay, here what I told you, left, right, right, left. Left, right, left 3, right 6. They are also between the two parallel lines only. Two parallel, but left, right, right, left. Left, right, right, left. Okay, either left, left, right, right. Okay, here left, right, aisa. Or here left, right, left, right, right. Okay, so who's your 4 and 6? So 3 and 5, 4 and 6. 4 is angle DBE. And DBE and BEG. BEG. Very important. Learn to write the angles. So angle 4 and angle 6. So with this, we finish the different types of angles, which are formed by two coplanar, or what you call parallel lines, and a transversal. Now you can have alternate angles and these things even for three lines, okay? But that will be little different, okay? They can be more than three lines, okay? So what is the main thing now we have come to is we need to know what are these corresponding angles and properties. What are the properties of these corresponding angles? Now, corresponding angles, very important. Corresponding angles, as I told you, they are in jodi. They are in jodi or pairs. They are in pairs. All corresponding angles will always be congruent. Now, this is the mark symbol for congruent. Short form of, what is the short form of congruent? You put an equal sign and I put a S. Write an S, sinusoidal sign, okay? That is called congruent. So, all corresponding angles are congruent. Remember, all corresponding angles will always be congruent. But congruent for what? Congruent for parallel lines. If the two lines are parallel, then all the corresponding angles will be congruent. Remember, if they are not parallel, if they are coplanar, then they will not be congruent. If they are coplanar, they will not be congruent. Only if they are parallel, they will be congruent. So, all corresponding angles will be congruent for parallel lines. Same way, all alternate interior angles will again be congruent for parallel lines. So, all alternate interior angles, that means whatever is angle CBE will be BEG. So, let's say CBE, this angle number 3, no? 3 and 6. So, if CBE is 80 degrees, then BEG also will be 80 degrees. Got it? Here also corresponding. If angle ABC, let's say angle ABC, ABC, let's say angle ABC is 110 degrees, angle BF also will be 110 degrees. They are congruent. Congruent means what? When two angles have the same measure, you have learnt it. They are called congruent. Same measure. Remember, corresponding angles, the pair, jodi is always congruent. Agar ye 110 hai, to ye bhi 110. Agar ye 120 degree hai, to ye bhi 120 degree hai. Remember, same way. If I say same way for alternate angles, they will always be congruent. So, if CBE, as I told you, if CBE is 70 degree, BEG also will be 70 degree. Okay? Same way, if he is whatever degrees, that much degrees will be for this. Same way, for two parallel lines, alternate exterior angles also will be congruent. So, whatever is the measure of ABC will be the measure of this thing. So, let's say ABC is 130 degree. How many? 130. So, GEH also will be 130 degree. So, if somebody asks me ABC is 130, how much will be GEH? You will say 130. Why? Because they are alternate exterior. So, remember, all corresponding, all alternate angles, whether it is interior or exterior, corresponding and alternate angles are always congruent. For what? For parallel lines. Corresponding and alternate angles are always congruent. Clear? What about interior angles? Interior angles are not congruent. Interior angles, this is the only odd man out. Interior angles are supplementary. They will total to 180. They will not be congruent. Okay? So, they are these angles. Interior angles I'm writing here, they are supplementary. Now you all have learned what are supplementary angles. Supplementary angle means two angles which add up or total to 180. If the sum of two angles is 180 degrees, then they are called supplementary angles. So what is the, for example, I'll give you, let's say CBE. So if I say CBE is 100 degrees, how much? 100. So how much will be BEF? So, 180 minus 100, 80 degrees. So, this 100 plus 80 will become 180. That means supplementary. So, if I say, let's say, this angle is 70 degrees. How much? 70 degrees. How much? 70. So, how much will be this? 180 minus 70, kitna? 110. So, this is 70, this will be 110. They are supplementary. Here, not supplementary. Here, they are congruent. If he is 60, he will be 60. If he is 90, he will be 90. I am just giving you an example, okay? But here, they will add up to 180. They are supplementary. So, all interior angles are supplementary. All corresponding and alternate angles, whether it is interior or exterior, they are always congruent. Corresponding and alternate angles congruent, interior angles will be supplementary. This is the main thing you have to remember in this lesson. Very important. But when are they congruent, I told you, or when are they supplementary? Only if the two lines are parallel. If they are coplanar, if they intersect, they will not be congruent, or they will not be, interior angles will not be supplementary. Okay? Okay, so you can write down, boys, please write down this, okay, and practice it before you go into the practice set. Before you start the practice set, write down this, draw a line, draw a diagram like this, and write down on your, in your own without looking. Write down the corresponding angle and check whether you have the same, whether it is correct or wrong. Because this is very important. Unless you learn this, you will not be able to understand the lesson. Okay? So please write this down, copy it down, and then write your own angle. Make your own, like a diagram, make this diagram and write it without looking and check with the answers. Okay? So you can pause here and do it.